Excel just got a major upgrade. There's a new Copilot function that allows you to use AI directly in the grid itself, just like any other formula. You can type equal Copilot directly into a cell, reference your data, and get answers or insights right where you need them. In this video, we'll explore what's new, how it works, and the ways it can help you save time. Hi, I'm Kevin, and let's dive in. Here I am in Microsoft Excel, the application that runs most businesses in the world, including the company I work at, the Kevin Cookie Company. Let's start with a really simple example of how to use the new Copilot function. First off, simply click into a cell. In my case, cell A2. To use the new function, you start with an equal sign. So here I'll type an equal, and then we type in the function name, which is Copilot. Here you'll see that it pops up as one of the available functions. Now we need to feed arguments into the function. To do that, we're going to open the parentheses, and here we see a helpful guide to help us feed in all these different arguments. Now, first off, it wants a prompt, and we're going to keep this really simple. I'll open my quotes, and here I could type in a prompt. Give me three cookie types. Here, I'll close the quotes, close the parentheses, and then we simply hit enter. And now Copilot's working, and this gives me three different cookie types, and here it spills into the adjacent cells. Along with simply entering in a prompt directly into the function, you can also reference other cells. Now, right over here, I have a column where I would like to enter in the description of each one of these cookies. So let's see if we could use the Copilot function to do this. Over here, I'll click into cell B2. And once again, let's enter in the Copilot function. So equal Copilot and open parentheses. Now, first off, it wants the prompt. So let's type that in. Give me a description of each. And here, I'll close that off. That's my prompt. But now I need to tell the function, or I need to tell Copilot what I would like a description of. So let's enter in a comma, and now I could enter in the context or the second argument of this function. Over here, I'll highlight these three different cells with my different cookie types. Then let's close the parentheses, hit enter, and now Copilot's working. And look at that, I get a description of each one of those cookies. Now, honestly, that text is really good. We could probably use that on our website or in our marketing materials. Here at the Kevin Cookie Company, we get a ton of customer feedback. Let's see if the Copilot function can help us quickly gauge the sentiment behind it. Here's a list of feedback that we've received here at the Kevin Cookie Company. Now, I'm hoping it's all positive, but you don't really know until you dig in. For all this feedback, I'd like to figure out the sentiment. So, is it positive? Is it average? Or is it negative? And over here, I would also like to categorize the feedback. Is it related to the product quality? Or maybe the customer service? It's important to have categories. Let's see if we could use the Copilot function to help us here too. Just like we've been doing, let's start with the equal sign, and then we'll type in Copilot. Then let's open the parentheses, and we have to enter in the prompt. So let's start by saying, evaluate these reviews. That's my prompt. Enter in a comma, and now we have to feed in the context. Well, I would like it to evaluate all of these different customer reviews. So I'm going to reference these cells. Now, here's the cool thing. You can also enter a second prompt and also reference additional data in the Copilot function. I'll enter in another comma, and here we're going to insert the second part of our prompt. I want to base it on these different column headers. So the headers that we saw in B1 and also C1. So over here, let's close the quotes, enter another comma, and here I'm going to enter in B1 through C1. And here I'll close the parentheses. Now you can't see those column headers right now, but those values are right underneath over here. Now let's hit enter, and Copilot's now processing. And look at that. Here I get all of the sentiment. And over on the side, I also get the category. Let's have a quick look just to make sure that it worked as we expected to. So here it says, delicious cookies with a perfect balance of sweetness. Highly recommend. Well, that sounds positive to me. Here it says positive, and it's related to the taste. The cookies were a bit too dry for my taste, but the flavor was good. So it has both negative and positive, and here it calls out neutral, and this is related to the taste. Let's go down a little bit more. Here the cookies arrived stale, really? Which was disappointing. Here it's negative, and that's related to the quality. So this is working exactly how I would expect it to. So now, instead of me sorting through all this feedback and putting down the sentiment and the category, I could just rely on Copilot to do this for me. When we look at the sentiment column, currently it just has text, positive, neutral, or negative. At least for me, I like just having a symbol. It's a little bit more visual. So up on top, let's actually change this column header. Currently it says sentiment, but why don't we change that to sentiment as positive, squiggly line, or negative? And then let's press enter and let's see if Copilot can factor that in. Ooh, look at that. Here I get a symbol and I can very quickly look at this to figure out if it's positive or negative. That helps, but I think a summary of the data would be even better. Next, we're going to look at how we could use the Copilot function together with other functions in Excel. I'd like to get a quick summary of all of this data that we see here. It's hard to tell if it's mostly positive, neutral, or negative. We can use the group by function to quickly summarize this customer feedback. To insert the group by function, let's enter the equal sign and then type in the function name, group by. Then I'll open the parentheses and down below we see all the different arguments that we have to feed into this function, starting with the row fields. So what's that? Well, this is the column or the columns that we want to group by. I want to group by all of these different symbols that we see right here, so I'll highlight these cells. Now that I entered in the first argument, let's insert a comma, and now we have to enter in the values. This is the data that we want to calculate or summarize for each group. In my case, we're counting up the number of these different symbols that appear. So again, I'll highlight all of these different cells. Then let's insert a comma, and then I need to specify the function that I would like to use. Well, I simply want to count up the number of these different symbols. So we're going to use the COUNTA function. Now that I entered in all of the different required arguments, let's close the parentheses and then hit enter. And look at that. We have 4 pieces of negative feedback, 1 neutral piece of feedback, and here we have 5 positive feedbacks for a total of 10 pieces of feedback. Hopefully you're starting to see the power of using the Copilot function. Now here's another neat thing. As our data changes, the Copilot function automatically recalculates. Now you'll notice here we have a mix of feedback, but what if I were to change all this to positive feedback? This is, after all, the Kevin Cookie Company, and we only get the best reviews. If I click into cell A2, you'll see that I used the Copilot function to generate all this feedback. Here it says, give me 10 reviews, give me a mix of positive and negative, but let's actually change this right here. Instead, give me only positive feedback, then I'll press enter, and here it regenerates 10 pieces of feedback, and what do you know? If we look over here, they're all positive. And if we look at our group by table right down below, we have 10 pieces of feedback and they're all positive. That's what I would expect. Let's switch gears and look at how Copilot can extract data from text, and we'll set it up so it works in a highly scalable way across large amounts of text. On this sheet, I have a list of customers who have requested a callback. To make this a little bit more efficient for me, I'd like to pull out the name and also the phone number of the customer. That way I don't have to fumble through and try to find it when I make the call. So right over here, let's use the Copilot function. I'll enter equal, and then here let's type in Copilot, then open parentheses, and then I need to enter in my prompt. Extract the name, here, close quotes, insert a comma, and then I need to reference the cells. So over here, I'll reference all of these cells, then close the parentheses and hit enter, and let's see if we can pull out the name. Here I have Sarah, Sarah, here we have Mike, Mike, and it looks like it successfully pulled out the name from all these different requests. That's good. Right over here, I would like to extract the phone number. And for this too, we could also use the Copilot function, and it works well. But let's say you have hundreds or thousands of rows you need to extract data from. You probably don't want to call Copilot for each one, since there is a limit to the number of calls you can make. So instead, we can make it more efficient. We can have Copilot help us figure out how to extract the data across a large data set using a regex function or a regular expression function. A regex function in Excel lets you use a search pattern to quickly find, extract, or replace specific text within a cell. So let's use Copilot to generate the pattern, and then we'll switch to native Excel to scale it. Let's click into cell C1. Let's type in the Copilot function. Here, I'll type in equal, Copilot, and then open parentheses. Now, for the beginning part of my prompt, I want a regex pattern that will pull out the phone number. So over here, I'll type in my prompt, return a regex pattern to match, and then let's close the quotes, insert a comma, and then I want it to pull out the phone number. So over here, I'll select cell C2, which simply says phone number. Then let's insert a comma, and then we're going to enter in our second prompt. So here, open quotes, and then I'll type in from this example. So I want it to look at this example right here. So let's close the quotes, insert a comma, and then here, I'll reference this cell right here, and then let's close the parentheses and hit enter. And let's see if it could pull a regex pattern. Now, that may look very complex, but this pattern will extract the phone number from this text or this cell right here. This pattern may look like foreign text, but it's actually very logical. So over here, it's looking for a phone number with an open parentheses, 3 digits, a close, 3 more digits, a dash, and then 4 digits at the end. If you look at all the phone numbers, they all match that pattern. Now that we have the pattern, we can place it into a regex extract function to pull out the phone number. So over here, I'll click into cell C3, and then let's type in regex extract. There we see the function name. Let's click on that. Now, first, I need to insert the text where I want to extract from. So over here, I'll select this cell. Then let's insert a comma, and right up above, I have my pattern that Copilot returned. So I'll click on this, then let's close the parentheses, hit enter, and beautiful, it pulls out the phone number. I'd like to apply this formula to all the rows below, but before I could do that, I need to make this an absolute reference. That way, they all reference this specific cell. To do that, over here, I'll place my mouse cursor here, press the F4 key, and that'll lock both the column and the row. Then I'll press enter, and over here, I can now apply this all the way down. Look at that. We now have phone numbers extracted from all these different callback requests. This is all dynamic. So let's say if instead of getting the phone number, I just want the area code. I'll click into this cell right here, and let's remove phone number and instead say area code from phone number. Then I'll press enter, and here Copilot updates the pattern. And then here, the regex extract function uses that new pattern to pull out the area code from all the phone numbers. That is so cool. Let's now pull everything together for one final fun example. We have some high school students visiting us here at the Kevin Cookie Company, and I'm on point to pull together an itinerary for them for all these different time slots. So what do I do? Well, let's use Copilot. So over here, I'll type in the function name. We've got Copilot. Then I need to type in my prompt. Here, recommend an itinerary for a class visit to the Kevin Cookie Company for all these different time slots. Then let's close the quotes, insert a comma, and then I need to reference all of these different time slots. So over here, I'll select these cells. Now I wanted to recommend an itinerary for high school students. So let's insert a comma, and then I could enter in another prompt. So here I'll insert quotes, type in my prompt for this grade level. And of course I need to specify what the grade level is. So I'll insert a comma, and then we could reference this cell right here. Then let's close the parentheses and hit enter, and let's see if it comes up. Ooh, look at that. We have a full itinerary, a welcome and introduction, a guided tour, interactive cookie baking demonstration. This sounds like a lot of fun. I'd like to do this. A Q&A session with bakers. Sounds like a fun day. Instead of high school students, let's change this to, let's say, kindergarten students. They'll probably have completely different interests. So over here, I'll enter kindergarten, press enter, and again, this is dynamic, and it updates the entire itinerary based on what kindergartners would probably like. Here we have a snack break, an interactive cookie decoration activity. It sounds a lot more catered towards kindergartners. Let's also use Copilot to evaluate how fun all these different activities are. So over here, I'll click into the fun rating column, and let's use Copilot again. I'll type in Copilot, and for my prompt, I'll say, rate these based on how fun these activities are. And if it's 1 exclamation mark, it's not as fun. If it has 4, it's really fun. Then I'll close the quotes to close out the prompt. Let's insert a comma, and here I'll reference all the different activities, close the parentheses, and hit enter. And look at that. It looks like the welcome's not really that fun. I kind of get that. It looks like the cookie decoration activity will be the most fun. I could agree with that. I think that will be. Over on the left-hand side, let's also add a visual for each one of these activities with an emoji. So again, let's type in the Copilot function, and for my prompt, I'll enter in give me an emoji for each. Then let's close off the prompt, and here I want to reference a cell. Well, I want to reference the activity. So over here, let's select cell C5 all the way down through the bottom activity, close parentheses, and look at that. I have an emoji for each one. Welcome and introduction, I have a hand waving. That makes sense. Here we have the snack break. I have a little cup, and down below we have a group photo, and there I have a camera. It's right on point. This is such a cool feature, but there are a few things to keep in mind. The Copilot function is not designed for heavy math or massive data sets. Excel has existing functions for those, but for everyday work, it's a time saver. You'll need a Microsoft 365 Copilot license tied to a work or school account. Unfortunately, no personal accounts yet. And remember, the results recalculate every time you open this sheet. So if you like something you see, make sure to save it. And also, if you're planning a class visit to the Kevin Cookie Company factory, drop a comment below and we'll create a custom itinerary and we'll even add in a fun rating. Thanks for watching and I hope to see you in the next video.